What's up, everybody? All right, hope y'all had a good week. Finally, Friday. Weekend is upon us. That's your weekend. Good one. You can see we've got a bit of a change of scenery here. I thought I'd check out this FDR Login Smoky Mountain map. Just fun. It's pretty interesting. Wouldn't say it's a huge map, but it's pretty good size. I haven't checked out all the areas yet. I've really just looked at where we're at now, which is area number one. I checked out a little bit of tower number one and tower number two. I haven't been up to number four yet. It's pretty interesting, though. It's mostly, well, so it's a lot of hills and mountains in the background. And we're precariously driving under this thing here. Hope it doesn't go anywhere. Anyway, so what I did was I calculated up how much equipment we had at the other map at Pacific Inlet, and then I modded the money in since we'd already worked so hard to buy all the equipment. I figured, well, go ahead and mod the money in for this map. That way we can pretend like we've moved our equipment to a different site. We've got all of our usual, got the fixed processor, the grapple loader, and the feather buncher, but I decided to use the FDR Login log trailer. This is the short rack. It could hold about three bunks of short logs there. And then I got the nice Peterbilt mod. It sounds really good. I'll fire it up. Yeah. Pretty cool. And then I decided to go back to the Tigercat skidder. I seem to like it a little bit better than the John Deere one. And something else new, let me switch over to here. I've got this Kenworth service truck. Nice. Got a welder and generator, air compressor, some tanks in the back. It's got an attacher back for hauling stuff, pulling things. Little toolbox back there is pretty cool. Unfortunately, it does not have a fuel tank on it, which I was hoping that was to be the case, so that way we could fuel up our equipment while we're out there. But we'll just say this is our service truck and kind of use it to drive around. Well, anyway, let's see. I was having a bit of a trouble here just a minute ago trying to get everything just really tight up in here. I've cut a few trees with the feather buncher, but they're all over there. I think I cut them on the wrong side of the landing. I should have cut them over here first and then drag them over there, but we'll get all that straightened out here in a minute. I wanted to go ahead and get started processing some of this wood that we got. Switch over to that profile. Go. I couldn't see. Had to get it. Cut on it. Grab it and had tried out FDR Logging Arctic map. I was hoping to have that one video. shouldn't. Having a lot of problems with processor grabbing the wood. Oh, the feller buncher wasn't cutting the trees good for some reason. I think that with his own map, he would have equipment, but it could have just been how much. Get it over here. Grab on it. Trying to make the pile a bit bigger. Practice process. Quite got down the discussion how far those trees. Okay, well, go ahead and get that loaded up. I know it's not much, but make sure the battery thing need it. The landing up. Yeah. Yeah, if you grab the logs too tight, it'll shoot them out of there. Oh no. Oh. Height here. Landing. Bit, that's close. Trying to get it positioned quite a minute ago, and I just close, I guess. Realizing how close you need to be or how far away you need to be. See how the logs are starting to jitter? Back it off just a little bit. Also got some work to do. Go to key. Moving the left stick. Straighten back up. Cool. Need some work on that. Well, we need to hop in our fellow buncher and get some more on the other side. Cramped or I hope y'all have a big weekend planned. Going to an ag expo, so I'm hoping that there'll be some forestry equipment over there to check out. Fun. I didn't go. Or cut over here and we'll. What we can do with this. Quite sure yet how I want to. Landing is so tight. I think I want to pull them up like this and go in between the machine. I'm kind of right there. Back around. Pillars. Tight. We'll have to get some more trees cut down and get this opened up, and then we can move our landing around a little bit. Probably should have done that to start with, but didn't have much time to get this put together, so I was kind of rushing to get all the equipment over here and get started so I can make the video for about 30 minutes and show you a little bit of the Smoky Mountain map. I do like the fact that most of these trees on here are pretty big. Makes for some pretty quick loads. That's good. Grab it good this time. You know, work. Hung up on something? Go. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep on this map. Pretty cool. I kind of like it. Continue on with the Pacific Inlet one though. I do want to work on that a bunch more and see how many loads we can get out of there. But we're gonna come over here and work every once in a while. All right, with everybody. Kind of give a change of scenery. Whoa, hung up on something. Oh. Well, we won't mess with that one right now. Trees cut over in that area, but it'll spring loose. I don't have something mapped right on Joy to Key because front's going up and the back's going up and down. It's crazy. Wonder what's got this tree hung up right here. I can front blade to kind of push it loose. Could have been that stump, but I don't think that was it. Right. I am going to be bringing different game content to the channel just whenever I can get to it. I've got Forza Horizon 3 and Forza Motorsport 6, which I really like playing. I've been big into the racing games, Xbox, well, PlayStation, Xbox, for a long time now. Do enjoy playing those, and I do have the new Blizzard Mountain add-on for Forza Horizon 3. So hoping maybe sometime this weekend I can get a little gameplay in, and then I can start bringing some of that to the channel. Plus, I've got American Truck Simulator, I like playing. I've got a pretty sweet Peterbilt that I've put together for that map or that game, so I can play a little bit of that. Just a matter of finding time to do it, because I've been trying to get this content for the most part every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, just to cut back on my time spent, putting together videos and stuff. I just decided to stick with Farming Simulator 17 for the moment, but I will be bringing some Forza Motorsports gameplay sometime soon, hopefully. Maybe next week or something, I can get a video or two in. Okay, let's do a little bit of processing over here, and then see if we can get at least this front bunk loaded, and then probably call it a video for this time. Where are we at? Okay, over here. I like having the butt ends of the dogs facing me, show how far away they are. Doing. The other thing, I was pushing my truck around. Still have not. I like the fact that this map has mostly all big trees. I haven't found any small ones yet. On the Pacific Inlet and Goldcrest Valley and where that other map is, they've a bunch of little small trees, and you get really one log out of like those trees to mess with. One good plan with those is to rip them up. This one so far, I haven't seen any of those little small trees and just run across them yet. That one right there was kind of a small tree. So much faster using a chainsaw to cut those trees up and delimit them and all. We're ready to get to the processor. boaters gonna My trailer all. Good. Looking pretty good. And before we hop out of here, I do want to hop in the service truck. We'll just go ahead and unhook that for now. We don't need it now. And let's take a spin around this Smoky Mountain map. I haven't looked at all this yet. Go ahead and, sure, we'll see if we can get up there. Stop off here first. Pretty rocky and terrain. Really, this is just a walking path, I think, or a four-wheeler trail or something. Whoa. Trees on this map. Cut them down. Okay, screw that. We'll just walk up it. Walking path anyway. Pretty steep. The fire tower up here. Go check this. And after this video, we will be getting back to Pacific. Probably we'd jump back over there. I may alternate or something. Something like that. Maybe just every once in a while we can come over here and work on Smoky Mountain. Oh, fell off the whole thing. Here we are. Okay, so we're looking out over, what is that? Fireweed Lake. Obviously, over there, there's a bunch of trees. Peter's not drawing them. Wait. Probably right over there. Oh, yeah, there's that little overhanging rock thing. Okay, let's hop down off of there. Back in our service truck and go check out the other little spots. Out of here. trees on this. Oh boy. Finally. Whew. Okay, that was a bad idea. So, we've already seen area number one because that's where we're logging at now. Area number two, just right up here, it's not much really to it. A quick little entrance and a small little landing, and very small, even smaller than number one. So good job, Jordan, you need this much room to work in. Can you, Oh yeah, I'm still in the, hold on a second. Go to key over to the game mode so I can drive without difficulties. Go. Got to cut that. Already ran into that at least once. Number two. Cut that out of the way. I think I did come up here and look at number three, but I have not seen number four. Here's number three. It's a little bit bigger. A little bit more room to work with. Let's see, that little path over there just goes up to that little fire tower. Then go up there. See, let's keep on going. Let's check out number four. Another tree to cut. So this is the furthest away from the sawmill right up here. Pretty good old drive. Distance wise, and a little bit rough to get up here. Again, not much of a landing. I definitely have to cut a few trees out to clear some room. And that's pretty much it. There may be another little spot you could get to, possibly up above Fireweed Lake in that little green area up there, but looks awfully tight getting there. Anyway, this is a Smoky Mountain map, and we'll be switching over here every once in a while to break up the pace, you know, of Pacific Inlet, because I do want to get a whole bunch more loads over at Pacific Inlet, and I'd like to see if we can't cut down maybe not every tree, but most of them, and see how many loads that is. I think we're already up to what, maybe load number 75 or 76 or something like that. So I got a bunch of loads in over there. I do want to continue that, but this will be fun just to do something a little different. And just hop over here once in a while and play a little bit, and then continue on back over at Pacific Inlet. Oh, look at that. There's a rock floating in there. Huh. How about that? Wonder if anybody has pointed that out to him. Pacific Inlet's got some floating trees, but I've never seen floating rocks. Hey Jordan, you got a floating rock up there. Alright. Well, we don't have room for the chipper just yet. We'll have to clear off a few more trees and maybe do some stump grinding. But anyway, so here we are back at the landing. Next time we'll have to get a few more trees cut. Kind of back right into this area over the top of the skidder. We need to clear out some room and do some stump grinding so we can have some places to work with. And not nothing over there. Not much over on that side either. There's mountains. All right, that's Smoky Mountain map. It's too bad I couldn't bring you the Arctic map. That's looks like a pretty cool little map, but like I said, I just had a lot of trouble cutting down the trees and then getting a process. The bug buncher seemed like it wanted to cut the trees before you even got to them, and then the processor wouldn't pick them up. You could get your head down there close to it and hit A, or in my case, trigger on the joystick, and it would cut the trees, but it wouldn't actually pick them up first like I normally do. So I'm not sure, those trees were kind of small too. I bet that was part of it. Anyway, let me check out one thing right before we go. Make sure that my truck is gonna clear the trailer. Already got one log basically right in the cab already. Think that'll work. Collision's making it work, so that'll be fine. Put a few more actually on that trailer, so I'm just gonna leave it right here. Put that strap on for now, just don't lose anything. Okay. So we'll hop over here to Smoky Mountain every once in a while and do a little bit more over here, but we're gonna be back on Pacific Inlet as soon as we can, so we can get a bunch more loads over there and then move on to a new site right there by the sawmill. Doing some loads there, but we need to move on to get some more areas cut. Okay, well, that's gonna be it for this video. Hope you've enjoyed watching this one and checking out Smoky Mountain map with me. My first time seeing parts of the map myself tonight. And anyway, like the video, hit that subscribe button, and leave me some comments if you see me do something over here. Like, for instance, we could do some clear cutting, or we could do some selective cutting with some of the dead trees, or even just do some thinning or something. But they really, this size tree needs either clear cut or select harvested. But anyway, just whatever you want to see. Let me know if you want to see something different. So anyway, so thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.